living room. Like two brothers and my one, but only annoying sister. We looked into one another's eyes and we knew something bad was going to happen. I was right. My dad looked at each of us intently and said solemnly. So solemnly, I thought someone had died. Everyone, no personal internet-connected devices until you are 18. I was speechless, flabbergasted. At that time, I was using my mom's phone to do my research on the internet. Yes, I was. Why? Because I was trying to write books. After reading my mom's psychology books, I was inspired to write one myself. And I was only 9. That meant 9 more years without my own pen. Now, my mom is a living room. Raise your hand if you have a living room. Put all moms together, you get mine. We call her Omi. Omi came to me and said, Noreen, it's okay. You already have books to read and your research on. You already have internet time daily on my phone. You'll get a phone in due time. 7 years from now. I said okay. And that was the fact. So, what does all of this have to do with electronic devices and environmentally friendly practices? A lot, actually. Just imagine if I had my own phone now. Most phones get spoiled early. Now, if that happens, that would mean from now till the age of 18, I would have used a total of 7 handphones. At least, counting my siblings, that would mean more than 7 times 4. Or 28 handphones. The experts are saying that electronic devices like handphones are causing damage to our environment. Yes, there are other electronic devices like television sets and computers. It turns out my dad has actually spreading effects on handphones to the environment. It turns out my dad was right. Hands up those who have a great dad. We love you, Dad! It's just like what my wise old dad used to say. He told me, solemnly, as if another person had died. Noreen, avoid electronic wastage, even though it is just a digital text. I was like, wow! That was the first time in my whole life somebody has ever told me not to waste electronic bytes. But, believe it or not, the deprivation of handphones has actually caused me to appreciate them more. Such deprivation on my part got me noticing the abundance of handphones to others. Handphones to them has become an addiction. I see my friends getting handphones because their mummies are upgrading theirs. I see the workable iPads people continue to use even with broken screens. I see the amount of eye contact people are having with their iPhones and iPads instead of their loved ones. And I see people snoring, streaming, and even sleeping with handphones. formal survey and found out that there were at least two phones per person in almost every house. And the number is cheap and interesting. After successfully feeling okay with the fact that I won't be getting my handphone until the age of 18, I find it weird for friends who treasure their lives in their handphones, not noticing the world around them. I didn't know what to do with my non-phone parts of my life. I felt lost. I felt isolated. I felt alone. And when you're lost, it's difficult to feel special, especially when you don't have a handphone that everyone else has. So I went back to my super loving mom and said, "Omi, I feel lost." And what did she do? She took me to the library. And off we went. For the first time, I read more than just books. There were journals, magazines, and comics which I had not bothered to touch previously. In the library, I see fewer people do to their handphones. And then I realized we're special. And ladies and gentlemen, it was the library that helped me find facts about electronic devices that blew me away. Forget about the fact that Singapore is gaining more momentum as an e-waste territory, with constant upgrading of personal devices, making fully functioning ones obsolete. Forget about the fact that we assure ourselves that it doesn't go to waste, but sold and exported to other countries for further use. Forget about the fact that we continuously recycle things, especially electronics. A seldom await the cash converters, only to buy more. Ladies and gentlemen, today I am a budget. I'm a speaker, and I learned the quality of spreading lessons learned from my mom and dad. Of course, I believe that electronic devices are physically damaging our environment. Of course, I believe that someone should solve the problem. We are the ones who have lost touch with our environment. We are the ones thinking that somebody else is solving the problem. So we dive into our headphones, looking for the latest Justin Bieber news or Korean dramas. We can cut down the use of handphones. School children do not have to bring handphones to school. We can just install more public phones for us to use. After all, handphones are originally for taking notes and making phone calls, not for looking at Facebook without end. I know my speech did not bore my room with a mountain of facts, but I rather remember the stories about what I told. About the dad, about what he said in the living room, about a girl who has to live without her own handphone until the age of 18. And one day, you realize what the truth is spoken, and you want to live a lifestyle without electronic devices, and you find it hard. Just remember, a girl was found out that not having a handphone until she is 18 is not a curse, but a blessing in disguise. Even if I can't tell you what those blessings are.